We're talking today about tens and cognition. This is going to sound really, really weird, but the question is, can I actually shock a part of my body and potentially improve my working memory, my ability to focus and concentrate? I know this sounds a little bit crazy, but I actually have a setup on me right now. This is a TENS unit. It's T-E-N-S, that stands for transcutaneous electrical nerve stimulation or neural stimulation. This has been around forever. Back in the dark ages when I was in school, we did a lot of different electrotherapy. We used TENS units. We used what's called neuromuscular electrical stimulation, galvanic stimulation. And at that time, what was really interesting was that the huge focus was really on using electrical units to make muscles contract, et cetera. And TENS was basically looked at as a tool that would potentially reduce pain, but I actually kind of call it the abandoned, lonely stepchild of the electrical stimulation world, because although people have known about it for many, many years, it kind of went out of favor because people didn't really understand how to use the technology. But way back in 2002, there were some studies that came out and they utilized a TENS unit on people with Alzheimer's disease and with cognitive dementia, or in the middle of mild cognitive impairment or decline, and they found that regular use of a TENS unit could actually improve their cognitive function. So studies went on 2002, 2005, 2015, and people keep reviewing this and are like, okay, it seems to work. So how in the heck does shocking a part of the body potentially improve cognitive function? Well, we now have some answers. A study that came out about a year and a half ago finally did some brain imaging and brain scans to look at how a TENS unit could influence what's going on in the brain that might improve focus, concentration, executive function, all these different cognitive skills that we often lose with different neurodegenerative diseases or with age. And what they found is that whenever we attach a TENS unit, and I'm set up like this study that they used to demonstrate this. What they found was that if we put a TENS unit anywhere on the body, but for this study, they used the wrist and then they turned it on. Now TENS units are very interesting because they in general are designed to just provide sensory stimulation. So what that means right now, I have this one turned on and it's running at a level 2. Now that level 2 means that I can kind of feel a little very, 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 very mild tingling on the skin and nothing else. I don't have any muscle contraction going on. If I turn this up enough, you can now start to see that my finger is contracting all on its own. I'm not trying to do that. So now I'm turning the TENS into something that's causing motor contraction, and I don't really want that because that's very uncomfortable. And I'm afraid I might make a rude gesture if I keep playing with it. So I've turned it back down now. So I now just have that mild tingling. This is generally how we tell people you want to use a TENS unit. When we have that going and we leave it on for a prolonged period, the brain is receiving sensory input, and that's going to drive a lot of blood flow changes, going to drive activation in different neuronal pools in the brain. And it's also going to shift brain activity and what we call brain wave activity. So you can go read about different brain waves, but what they found was that TENS particularly increased theta wave activity. Sorry, gamma wave activity. I was thinking about a different study. Gamma wave activity. Now, gamma wave activity is associated with high levels of focus, high levels of attention. And whenever we're trying to remember things, we're trying to do hard cognitive work, we will see increased levels of gamma activity in the brain. So whenever we turn this thing on and we just let it run, over a period of time, it creates changes, like I said, in blood flow, neuronal pool activation, but it also increases gamma activity in the brain, which is probably why in people with cognitive impairments of any type, we might see an improvement in their working memory, their ability to regulate their emotions, their ability to communicate, because all these things have been seen in different studies. So I wanted to bring this up because, like I said, in the general world, TENS has kind of been abandoned, honestly. I see people kind of using it, but they almost always exclusively say TENS is for pain and for nothing else. And nothing could be further from the truth. And the reason that TENS, I think, fell out of favor was, number one, it can take a lot longer than a lot of other electrical stimulation devices, which meant that if you went to your doctor or your therapist and you're sitting there and they're putting a TENS unit on you for 10 minutes, it's probably not going to do very much. What you need are long-term regular stimulations with the TENS to see changes in the brain. It actually will make your brain more plastic. It'll make it change, but you have to give it time. Now, we are currently living in the very best time ever for this because everyone on the planet that has access to Amazon, at least, or the internet, can buy a TENS unit. These are have reached the point that prescriptions are no longer required. So you can buy a TENS unit, a decent one, for $35 to $45 on Amazon. I recommend people go a little bit more expensive, because if you're going to try to do some cool stimulation parameters and change things, you want something that has a little bit more functionality. But we're still talking about a $75 to $80 purchase that you can use for years and have truly dramatic effects on brain function, on pain, on muscle function. And all that sounds a little bit crazy from this unit, but the key here is that we have to use it for prolonged periods. So again, if you're only going to use it twice a week when you're at the therapist's office, it makes sense that no one thought that TENS was useful. But if you look at it from a brain-based perspective, which is what we do, we now know and understand that we can use this thing and we can change brain function over time, and we can use it for a diverse range of different issues, including improvements in cognition. Couple of key points here. If you're going to try this stuff, probably talk to somebody that knows what they're doing. You can look up the studies online, go to Google Scholar, put in TENS units in cognitive function or whatever. You can read the studies. Most importantly are knowing when not to use a TENS or any kind of electrical stimulation device like this. If you have metal implants of any kind or electrical implants of any kind in your body, you are absolutely not supposed to use these devices without running it past your healthcare provider. So for us, it's an absolute contraindication. You have a pacemaker? No. You have a new hip? No, we're not going to use any of that. Also pregnancy. In general, it's probably something that you can work around, but I don't take any risk with this. You shouldn't either. So make sure if you're going to use a TENS unit, you've had anything done like that, that you consult with your healthcare provider. This is a kind of a public service announcement to say, you know what? These devices fell out of favor, but they work. They are incredibly useful if you understand how to use them, and just recognize that the goal isn't to change what's happening here, it's to change what's happening here. And that often takes longer periods of stimulation, which means that if you're a coach, your clients need a device of their own. And if you are a patient or a client of somebody that is a Z Health practitioner and you want to try this, you're going to have to shell out a little bit of money, but it is absolutely worth it because it can make a huge change in how you function in life, all right? Not many people would think shocking your wrist can make you think better, remember stuff better, and speak better, but in fact, that is what we see in the research. And hopefully we'll continue to see this grow as time goes on, all right? If you have questions about this, put them in the comments. And if you wanna know more about utilizing kind of electrical stim like this, also let me know that, because there is a lot of information out there. We just shared a bunch in one of our recent courses called No More Mindless Mobility. And so it's something I really enjoy talking about, because this is awesome for people to be able to sit at the TV, watching Netflix, binging on whatever you want, and also be working on your brain at the same time. All right. So think about that. Have a great week.